morning student, welcome back to the online classes for Triveni Memorial School. So today we are going to start the 14th chapter for class 4, that is animals in transport. So earlier student, what happened? In the earlier times, people used to travel by using certain vehicles which were driven by the animals. Okay, as you can see here, this is a tonga and this is an elephant safari. Okay, so let's begin. So in the past, human travels only on foot. So earlier, very ancient time, people used to travel from one place to another with the help of their foot. They used to carry their loads themselves. They used to carry their loads and luggage by themselves. Later on, what happened? They learned to domesticate the animals. So as you are aware, in the previous chapters we have studied that animals are very useful to us because they provide us various useful products, as well as we can use them for carrying the load and doing a certain work. So that is how the earlier people, they started to learn how to domesticate these animals. And one of the most important invention was made there at that time, which made the revolution in the field of transportation. So because of the invention of the wheels, it brought a revolution in transport. Okay, what is that invention led to? The carts which were fitted with the wheels were used to carry the people and goods from one places to another. Now the people have developed a car by which the wheels were fitted on those carts, and because of that, this helped the people. It made the transportation from one place to another and even carrying the goods from one place to another by the people easy. These carts were pulled by the animals. So these carts which were having the fitted wheels, these were pulled by what? By the animals. So next is mode of transport in past. So in the earlier time, what happened? Sunita's grandfather had to travel all over India as part of his job. So her grandfather used to travel a lot because of his job. So when he was young, there were tongas, camel cart, bullock carts were the main mode of transport in the towns and cities. So in the earlier time, these were the main modes of transportation. So as you can see here in a diagram, this is a tonga which is pulled by a horse, and you can see a bullock cart. There are two pairs. There is one pair of bullock cart, that is two bulls are used being here for carrying the bullock cart. Okay, there are also camels. These camels can pull the cart, that is why it is called as a camel cart. So similarly, you can see still them in a small towns and villages, but now because of modernization, you cannot see them in the cities and towns, but you can still see such type of mode of transportation in small villages and towns. Next is animals used in transport today. So there are basically three animals which are being most commonly used animals for the transportation purpose. These are camels, elephants and mounts. So we will discuss one by one in this slide. So first one is your camel. So camel is also known as ship of the desert. Why camel is known as ship of the desert? Because it can adjust itself to the desert conditions. Okay, it can stay without water and food for several days. So the camel can live without water and food for several days, and plus it can withstand the heat of the desert. There is very high temperature in the desert area. Because of that, the camel can adapt itself. That is why it is called as the ship of the desert, and it is being used commonly for the transport in desert area. Next one is your elephant. So in the forest, the elephant helps to move heavy logs from one place to another. So this is also useful for us human, because these elephants are generally helping us to carry this log of wood in the forest area from one place to the another. The next one is your mount. So here you must have seen people riding on horses, ponies and mules at hill station. So you might have visited in certain hill station area. So you also might have tried riding on these certain animals. Okay, so they are also used to carry the goods over a distance. So these animals not only helping them in riding, but also in helping them to carry the goods from one place to another. So these animals are called as mounts. In the mountain region, the animals such as donkey, mules and yaks are being used to carry the loads. So as you can see here, this girl is riding the horse, and you can see here the mule and the yak carrying the load on the mountain region. Next is that dogs and reindeers are being used to pull the wheelless cart. So there is a wheelless cart which is being pulled by the reindeer or the dog. These wheelless carts are called as the sledges. So you can see here in the diagram, this is a reindeer which is carrying or pulling the sled. This is not having any, this is a wheelless cart, there is no wheel. And generally these are being found in a region where the land is covered with ice or snow. You can see that in the Santa Claus carrying the Santa Claus riding the sledges which is pulled by the reindeers. Next is, in earlier days what you can observe that elephants were being used in the battlefield. So in the earlier war which were taken place in the ancient time, in that case the elephants were being used and the king rode an elephant with pride. So you can see here in the diagram the king sitting on the elephant and they used to ride with pride. So let's move on to the next slide, that is on special occasions. So you must have seen a bridegroom riding on a decorated horse in the marriage procession. So this is common tradition which was being followed in our country. You might have seen that the bridegroom generally he rides on the decorated horse for his marriage. Sometimes a buggy is also used. A buggy is a four-wheeled luxury coach which is pulled by one or two horses. So as you can see here, this is a marriage buggy. It is being decorated nicely and it is being pulled by two horses. This is a specifically designed wheeled luxury coach. Then people in some tourist places enjoy the buggy ride. So even in certain tourist places, people enjoy these buggy ride. Then next is, you might have seen an animal sanctuary. When you visit any animal sanctuary, the tourists on an elephant safari enjoy watching the animals. So you can see here in the diagram, in an elephant safari, the people, the special arrangements are being made where the people can sit on this elephant and enjoy the whole safari ride. Next is, as you are aware that brave children of our country are given the bravery award on Republic Day. So there is a Republic Day parade and in that some brave children are given this award for their bravery. They also ride on beautiful decorated elephant to take part in the Republic Day parade. So here you can see here these children are being riding the elephant which are being properly decorated and they take participation in the Republic Day parade. Then you might have seen that we can ride the camels or elephants at some fair and amusement parks as well. So there are certain animals like camels and elephants also there. We can ride those animals in the amusement parks or certain fair. The last topic here is, that is care of animals. So as you are aware, we should, animals, these are providing us very useful product and they are also important for the transportation in the earlier times. So people have started domesticating these animals, so we must take proper care about them, and these are the various method in which we can take care of the animals. So take proper care of your domestic animals. How can we do that? First of all, give them proper food and clean drinking water. So proper food and clean drinking water should be provided to them. Next is giving them proper shelter. So we are living at our home. Similarly, they require a proper place where they can stay. So that is, we have to build them a proper shelter. And the shelter protects them from heat, cold and rain. Clean their shelter regularly. So we must clean their shelter in a regular manner. Next is keeping them clean by giving them a bath regularly. So we should bathe them regularly, which will keep them clean. Next is, do not force them to work beyond their capacity. Be kind to them. So there is certain capacity of the animal to do the work. So we should not force them beyond their capacity. Next is, do not beat the animals when they refuse to work. We should not beat the animals. Okay. It is quite possible that they may be ill or injured or tired. So we should understand these animals. We should be more careful about this because they cannot speak. So we should keep an understanding. We should maintain that much understanding that we should not beat the animals and we should care about them. Next is, make sure that the hoof of the animal like horse and ox are protected with the horseshoe. So here you can see here there is a horseshoe which is U-shaped structure which is made up of iron. So this you can see here, this is the hoof of the horse and it has to be protected by, this is made made up of U-shaped horseshoe. It must be fitted with the on the hoof of these animals. It will protect their hoof part. Okay. The next one is, when an animal falls sick, take them to a veterinary doctor for the treatment. So as you are aware, when we fall sick, we need a doctor for our treatment. Similarly, if your pet animals or your domesticated animals are being falling sick, then we must take them to a specific doctor. Those doctors are called as veterinary doctors. So here you can see a veterinary doctor with a sick animal. He is treating this sick dog. Okay. So last part we have to discuss here is about the exercise. So first multiple choice question here is, in the past the human travels on dash. So were they using cars, foot or boat? So earlier people, what they used to do, they used to travel on the foot. Next is, the tongas are still a mode of transport in, where you can find still these tongas, cities, big towns or villages. So you might find these tongas still as a mode of transport in the villages. Next is, fill in the blanks. First of all, the dash is called the ship of the desert. So which animal is called as the ship of the desert? That is your camel. Next is, dash is used to pull the sledges in the snowy region. So what are the sledges? The one which is not having the cart, which is not having the fit, the wheels attached to it, that is called as sledges, and these are generally found in a snowy region. So they are generally pulled by a reindeer or the dogs. Next is, a dash is a four-wheeled luxury coach which is pulled by the horses. So four-wheeled luxury coach is your buggy. Next is, you have to write down the name of the means of transportation is provided here. You have to write down the name here. So first one, as you can see here, it is elephant. It is carried by elephant. Next, you can see here the camel, that is the ship of the desert. And the last one, you can see here, this person is riding the horse. So the right answer is horse. Next is section B of the exercise, the first multiple choice question. First of all, and dash is used to transport heavy logs in the forest. So which animals help us to transport the heavy logs in the forest? Elephant, donkey or the camel? So the right answer is your elephant. Next is, when our pets fall sick, we take them to a dash doctor. So the person who treats the sick animals, those are called as veterinary doctor. So if a pet animal falls sick, we take them to a veterinary doctor. So right answer is B option. Let's move on to the next type of question, that is very short answer type of question. First of all, name two animals which are used in transport. So which are the two animals which are used for transportation? Your elephants and horses. Next is, which animal is known as the ship of the desert? The animal which is known as ship of the desert is your camels. Next is your short answer type of question, student. First of all, how did the invention of the wheel bring about a revolution in the transportation? Okay, how this invention of the wheel helped or brought a revolution in transportation? Because in the past, the men travel only on the foot, as we have discussed in this slide, that the earlier men used to travel on the foot and carry their luggage themselves. They used to carry their luggage by themselves. By the invention of the wheel, it has brought a revolution in the transport, and the carts which were fitted with the wheels were used to carry the people. Because of these wheels, now the man has developed a cart fitted with the wheels, and this is going to help to carry the people as well as their goods from one place to another. This has made the transportation easy. And these carts were being pulled by which animals? Like there are certain animals which help in pulling those carts. These were horses, donkeys, camels, ox, etc. Next question is, what is a horseshoe? How it is useful? So a horseshoe is a U-shaped structure. As you can see here, this is a horseshoe. It is a U-shaped structure which is made up of iron. And what it is used for? It is being used to protect the hoofs of the animal like ox and horses. So as you can see here, this is the hoof part and this is your horseshoe. This is fitted in this manner so that it will protect the hoof of the animal like horse and ox specifically. So let's move on to the last part, that is long answer question. First of all, why is a camel called as the ship of the desert? So camel is being known as the ship of the desert because it is well adjusted to the desert condition. There is a specific desert condition, and the animals like camels are having a good adaptive capability. Because of that, they are found there. So it can withstand without, it can stay without water and food for several days. This is one of the basic feature which help it to stay in the desert condition, because it can live without food and water for several days. And next is it can withstand the heat of the desert. So there is very high hot temperature and in the desert. Because of that, which animal survive there? That is your camel. Next is it can walk easily on the sand because of its padded feet. Next characteristic which help him the camel to adjust in the desert is their padded feet. It helps them to walk easily on the sand. The last question here is, how should we take care of the domestic and the pet animals? So in what way we can take care about the domestic animals as well as our pet animals? So first of all, we can take care of our domestic and pet animals in the following way. First of all, we give them proper food and clean drinking water. So this is the basic thing, that is food and water is the basic necessity which is required by us humans as well as plants and animals to survive. So we must give them proper food and clean drinking water. Next is giving them proper shelter. So as we are staying in our home, these animals also require a proper place to live. So that is why we should give them a proper shelter. Next is keep them clean by giving them a bath regularly. So we should keep them clean by bathing them regularly. Next is be kind to them. Do not force them to work beyond their capacity. So every animals, every organism have their capacity. So we must not force them to do work beyond their capacity. Next is do not beat the animal. We should not be cruel to the animals. We should not beat the animal. Next is take them to the veterinarian for regular checkups and treatment when they are ill. So we should take them to a veterinarian doctor for their regular checkup as well as for their treatment when these animals fall sick. Okay. So by this we are completing this chapter. Hope to see you in my next video. Till then, take care. Thank you.